Today, we will make the HTML progress bar web accessible. Progress bars indicate that the user's request has been received and the application is making progress towards completing the requested action. We will be covering both horizontal and circular progress bar in our tutorial today. Hi, I'm Skill Singh, and on this channel, I help you build web accessible applications and share awesome UI and ADA tips. First, let's discuss how a web accessible progress bar should behave when interacting with assistive technologies. Screen readers such as JAWS or NVIDIA should announce the progress updates as they occur. If the progress bar is labeled, then the label text should be mentioned as well. One thing to note here is that the opinions may differ on how assistive technologies should handle this. Announcing the progress is one of those opinions, and therefore not normative. Following WAI-ARIA attributes should be used to make the progress bar web accessible. Role equals to progress bar. Remember, progress bar is always read-only, and the user cannot alter its value. When we add role progress bar, it adds an implicit ARIA read-only value of true. Next, ARIA value min, the minimum value that the progress bar can have. Normally, it starts from 0. ARIA value max, the maximum value that the progress bar can have. Finally, we have ARIA value now, which indicates the current value. Now, this value should be updated dynamically to indicate the progress to the assistive technologies. We can update ARIA value now attribute using JavaScript. We can omit the current value if the progress cannot be determined. Next, if you are using progress bar to describe the loading progress of a particular region of a page, then first we should use ARIA described by to point out the current status, and set ARIA busy attribute to true until the region is fully loaded. Now let's jump into our code to develop web accessible HTML progress bars. Alright, we have a very basic HTML page wherein we have couple of text boxes and then couple of buttons. On click of save button, we will be displaying two progress bars, horizontal progress bar and the circular progress bar. To achieve this, I have a very simple div in my HTML, and there are very great tutorials that you can refer to on YouTube. For horizontal scroll bars, this is the list that you can see, and for the circular one, I personally use this tutorial from Coding Nepal. Now let's come back to our HTML. If we look into our div, I have given a class progress div to this entire section. This div is for the horizontal progress bar that we see in our browser, and I'm using Bootstrap's progress bar classes to display the progress bar in our HTML, and this is looking good for a visual users, but for the non-sighted users, this doesn't make sense. We will be adding the ARIA attributes that are needed to make it accessible. The second div that we have is actually for the circular progress bar in our HTML, and we also have the CSS that is needed, so you can refer to the CSS in the GitHub. I'll be sharing the GitHub link in the description below. Now let's get back to our HTML and see what all is needed to make these progress bars ADA compliant or web accessible. So let's get started by adding the role, which should be the progress bar. So we are working on a progress bar, so we have to define a role equals to progress bar. Next, we have to add ARIA hyphen value min. Using this attribute, we can say, okay, it should start from 0. Next, we can have ARIA value max, and this can go up to 100. We have to add one more ARIA attribute, which is ARIA value now, and let's set it to 0 when the page loads. So far we have added role, which is a progress bar, aria value min, which is set to 0, aria value max, which is set to 100, and aria value now, which is set to 0 by default when the page loads. Now let me refresh my browser and click on save. And while this is loading, let's inspect what we have in our DOM that is rendered. If I go here, we have role progress bar, aria value min, aria value max, and aria value now, which is set to 0 and is not getting updated. Now using JavaScript, we have to update this attribute. Let me cover what I have done so far to display these progress bars. Okay, so I have an event handler on the click of btn save, which is the ID for my save button here. I'm calling a start progress bar function. Within this start progress bar function, I'm removing and adding certain classes to display the progress bar and then set the things in motion. Okay, so this section is for the horizontal progress bar and this section is for the circular progress bar that we have in our HTML. I'm also adding some class, which is inactive style, for reducing the opacity of the background and stopping the user click when, if I try to click on this, it should not be clickable. Okay, and then finally, I'm setting an interval that, okay, after every half second, I'm calling the update progress bar. Within the update progress bar, I have an if condition that it should always be less than 100. We don't want to go past the 100% mark. I'm adding the value of 3. I'm doing an increment of 3 for every update progress which is called. And then to this horizontal progress bar, I'm increasing the width with this counter value. And then this, the text that we see within this progress bar is coming from this text. So this is called as jQuery chaining. So this is one of the features of jQuery, that you can keep adding functions to your selector. Similarly, for the circular progress bar, I'm just adding the text to it. Now let's add, or let's update, the aria value now attribute for the horizontal progress bar first. So using the jQuery chaining method, we can say attribute, and we have to specify what attribute want to update. So in our case, it's aria value now, and what should be the value of it. So I'm gonna set it to I. Let's save this. Let me inspect this element. It should update the aria value now value as well. So it's updating the text already, and now with this little JavaScript change, it's updating the attribute value of aria value now. Now let's go back and do it for the circular progress bar as well. Let's go back to our div section, and this is the parent div for the circular progress bar that we have. So to this, let's go ahead and add role equals to progress bar and add aria value min. This should be set to 0. Aria value max, it should be set to 100. And then aria hyphen value now, let's set it to 0. And then in our JavaScript, within the update progress bar section, we have to update the value or the attribute aria value now for this circular section as well. So I have copied this class, and then immediately after this, I can look for that div. So let's find that div, then add an attribute, and we need to pass aria value now, and this should be set to I. So now let's inspect this element, the circular progress bar that we have. Let's refresh and verify we have role progress bar, aria value min, and the other attributes. Now let's click on save, and it should start updating the aria value attribute as well. It's also updating the aria value along with the current value. This is how we make horizontal and the circular progress bar web accessible. Now, before we start listening to what assistant technologies like JAWS read out, let's comment on the code for the circular progress bar. Let's go back to our HTML section. I'll commenting out the second div. Let's save it. Let's refresh to verify it's gone. We only have one progress bar, which is the horizontal progress bar. Now let's run our JAWS to see what JAWS reads out. I'm using JAWS version 2019, going to the save button and pressing spacebar key to activate that button, and let's have a listen what it is being announced.
Date of birth, upload picture link, cancel button, save my changes button, 2, space, 4, 49, 91, 100.
So, if you listen carefully, it's reading out the progress like 4% or 49 or 100. So it's reading it in an interval, which is a good user experience, so that it's not reading each and every increase in the percentage. To make the user understand it better, we should use another ARIA attribute, which is ARIA value text. So let's go ahead and add it to our HTML. Within this div, I'll need to add another attribute, which is ARIA value text. So by default we can say progress bar initiated, and then within our JavaScript where we are updating these attributes, we need to update this the another attribute as well. So we can do it by adding another if conditions within this. So I'll say if the value of I, the iterator that we are using, is greater than 50, but it should be less than 70, so that we are getting into a range of 50 to 70. What we want to do is we want to update the attribute ARIA value text to something. Okay, so let's grab this progress bar. Let's get this identifier, and then we want to update the attribute. We want to update this ARIA value text, and we want to set it to loading is in progress. I have my JAWS running. Let's refresh our page. I'll be tabbing through again the same sequence and have a listen when we press on the save button.
Activate, press space bar. Space. Progress bar initiated. Loading is in progress.
All right, so JAWS announced the initial state, which is progress bar initiated, the ARIA text that we wrote. So the ARIA value text that we gave, progress bar initiated. And we also added another check that when the variable I is in the range of 50 to 70, it should call out loading is in progress. Now this is more helpful to the end user. Similarly, we can do the same thing for the circular progress bar. Okay, let's go ahead and uncomment the sections for the circular progress bar, and we'll comment the sections for the horizontal progress bar. The reason I'm doing this thing is so that it should not interfere with two progress bars running at the same time, and let's not confuse the assistive technology to which progress bar it should update to the end user. Okay, now instead of this thing, let's put this section here. I'll uncomment this HTML part as well, and let's go ahead and comment on this section. Also, we need to add this attribute, which is ARIA value text. So let's go ahead and add it. And we'll say circular progress bar initiated. Now you can have more meaningful copy text for your scenarios, right? This is just for this demo purpose. So, all right, we have this ARIA value text set to the circular progress bar, adding the attribute ARIA value text when it's within the range of 50 to 70. Okay, now let's go ahead and refresh it and see if our circular progress bar is displayed. It's working fine. Now my JAWS is running. Let's have a listen what it reads out while I press the spacebar button to activate the progress bar. Let's have a listen.
Space. Circular progress bar initiated. Loading is in progress.
Awesome. So it read out or it announced the initial state of the ARIA value text attribute, which was circular progress bar initiated. And when it reached a certain range of 50 to 70, it updated the ARIA value text attribute and it announced loading is in progress. I believe that this video was helpful. Please like this video to keep me motivated so that I can continue creating great content for you. See you in the next video. Till then, keep coding.